Welcome. I have the absolute pleasure of introducing Josiba Achotegui. He is a professor at the University of Barcelona and has taught courses for more than 15 years on migration and mental health at the University of Berkeley. He's considered one of the world's leading specialists in the area of migration and mental health. And Ned Edicionis has published his previous books, Migratory Intelligence and the Ulysses Syndrome, which just came out in 2020. So it is our absolute pleasure and honor to introduce Dr. Josipa, and I will turn it over to you.
Thank you, thank you. Thank you very much, especially Adelaide Hobbs, for all the excellent work you have done to make this session possible. Many contacts, many emails for to prepare this session. Thank you also for your kindness. And for me, it's a honor to participate in this session. And good morning, everybody. In Spanish, is in the afternoon. But it's fantastic, no? This possibility of connection. Very well. I can begin my presentation. Very well. Yes. I will give a holistic global vision is a very broad subject. The idea of the Ulysses syndrome as a chronic and multiple syndrome related to migration in extreme conditions. This is the index of my presentation. The first part is the framework, very briefly, but the framework of today migration, of the context of migration. The first idea, I think, is the idea that it's very important rehumanizing migration. When addressing migration, there are numerous studies about the economic factors, the demographic factors, all these very significant. Very often, the human psychological side of migration is left aside. And it's very important the rehumanizing migration. Humans are good migrants, as stated by science. The ability to successfully migrate to very different environments is one of the characteristics of our species and one of the reasons for our evolutional success. This is very clear. Homo sapiens sapiens living in all on all the climates, in all the contexts. And this capacity has the origin in for 6 million years, more than 20 species of Homo sapiens from human primates have emigrated from Africa, colonizing the entire planet. The last group was the Homo sapiens sapiens. Barely 7,000 generations ago, all of modern man came from a small group like us who live in a region of Kenya. We know very well this concept for the studies of male Y chromosome and female mitochondrial DNA. The two lines go to a point in Kenya, the origin of the majority of the mankind. Our ancestors were immigrants, no? Que hay paintings in South Africa. And we can see the gene related to the dopaminergic system that increase the capacity to migrate, especially the genes of the long receptor allele DRD4 of dopamine are related to capacity to explore, to migrate. And we can see in America, for example, Native America of the North have 32% for this allele. But in the native people of South America have 69% of this allele, because this group was the last group to migrate. The last group have more level of this allele of dopaminergic system. The population with long alleles of this gene increased by 4% every 1,600 kilometers south of America. In the south, more level of this allele, because was the last group in the humanity to migrate. Other part of humanity emigrate to the south, a group to the north, other group to the south. Migration has formed an extremely important part of the history of mankind and its collective references. Abraham's journey, the trip is a symbol of personal transformation. It has a spiritual aspect. This is the landscape of our origins in Africa, but today this region suffer terrible drugs and wars. But today is very difficult, is almost impossible to migrate. In this region, there are the Dadaab refugee camp, one of the most important refugee camps in the world. Very different the situation related to our origin as a species. Today, the Mediterranean Sea, which has been a sea of culture, of interchange, of civilization, is today a wall, a barrier, a ditch. Immigrants arriving to Canary Island, hiding at the help of merchant ships. It's a very difficult situation for to their migrations. The walls that exist in Europe, and these walls are increasing today. Today, the journey of people who migrate will be almost impossible. The planet is increasingly full of anti-migrant walls. This is the wall in San Diego, California, but there are walls in India, Malaysia. This is the comparison, no? The history of migration and the terrible situation of today. All the text is in my webpage. The second point is Migration of Yesterday and Today. This is a book we wrote in the 90s about the research carried out in the 1890s 90s of the mental health of the migration of this time. The comparison with today's migration is the origin of the idea of Ulysses syndrome. It's more difficult to migrate today. We have studies for the 80s with a migration in very different conditions. Several million Spaniards emigrated to Europe and America. There are images of emigrants who left Spain, many poor Latin American. Photograph of Spanish emigrants in the 60s taking a boat to Argentina from my Spanish port, Bilbao. I am from Bilbao. In my family, a lot of migrants to America. I know very well this situation. But today, emigrating has become a very difficult process for millions of migrants. This is the situation in Europe. Terrible image, but the situation is similar in all the planet. This image of the border of Melilla about the time of slavery. Very similar, the image of the times of slavery and the image of these migrants arriving to Europe. It is very different to migrate in a ship, as my family parents, to migrate in a patera. It's a radical change in the condition of the migration, and this is the issue of my presentation, to migrate in a extreme situation. And this is the image. I think that there are three distinguishing characteristics of 21st century migration. The first, family breakup. Men, women, and even children emigrate, but they do so alone. Previously, it was difficult to emigrate with the family, but it is now often impossible. Many different laws explicitly forbid. There are technique in January forbid the migration. The second characteristic is the radical structural social exclusion for millions of migrants. And the third point is the criminalization of migration. It's the first time in the history that migrate is a crime punished by the law. It's a terrible change in the condition of on migration. There are a lot of theories about the cause of migration, but we have data today that migration has decreased. So many barriers in the end, they have stopped migration. Even counting the refugees is very, very interesting, data. How many immigrant population is there in the world? 2.3%. Is a number very, very low of migrants in comparison with the idea that exists in the media and about migration. 2% of population in the world is a number very, very relative. Migration from right to crime is a terrible change. The right to emigrate is included in the Declaration of Human Rights, but today it's a crime in various countries. In some countries. This is the first part for the to do a frame of the the situation of the reality of migration. The second part is obviously the study of psychological reality of this migration. We work with the concepts of stress and migratory mourning, basing concepts the stress and mourning, and we work with explanations based in psychosocial, cognitive theory of stress, psychoanalytical theory of mourning, various evolutionary psychiatry, different perspectives, share global vision. Everybody know the concept of stress. There are a lot of bibliography. Everybody know the concept of mourning. I have a book with the study of the specific characteristics of migratory mourning. I consider that there are 12 specific characteristics of migratory mourning. I will explain two or three more relevance, but the migratory mourning is different than other mournings. It is important to understand in reality. Migratory mourning is a partial mourning. It is different from mourning the loss of a loved one. It's a mourning brought on by temporal and spatial separation, no disappearance. There are the loss of a loved one and disappearance, but in migration are a temporal and spatial separation. And related to this idea, the migratory mourning is a recurrent mourning. It's a recurring mourning that comes and goes in the life of immigrants who live more than ever now in the two countries. Yeah, I remember the case of immigrant arrive our consultation going with two votes, one for he and the other for the country of origin. It's a situation of living in two worlds. It's a recurring mourning. And I have also the model that there are 7 relevant mournings in migration. Family, a loved one, language, culture, land, colors, smells, light, temperature, social status, contact with the identity group, the group of belonging, and physical risks. A very important number of mournings to elaborate. For me, the more important concept is migratory mourning. Migratory mourning is a part of migratory process. Migratory process has positive parts, but has a part of problem, of tension, of stress, of mourning, is the migratory mourning. But when migration is possible to live in good conditions, it's possible the elaboration of migratory mourning. But when migration is living in extreme condition, it's impossible to elaborate the migratory mourning. And the migrant live a situation of tension, of psychological difficulties. I consider that there are 3 intensities in the migratory mourning: simple mourning, complicated mourning, and extreme mourning. Simple morning, immigration with family, documents, complicated morning, situation of discrimination, but is possible to improve. Extreme morning, undocumented migrant, in this situation is almost impossible to have success in migration. The Ulysses syndrome is an extreme variation of migratory morning. It's a specific migratory morning related to migrating extreme conditions. But the Ulysses syndrome, it is not a mental disorder, it's a morning. Morning is a normal situation in the life. Including extreme morning is a situation in the life of people. It's different for mental disorder that has the mental disorders have other characteristics. The Ulysses syndrome is in the area of stress or mourning, in the area of mental health. Migration is a risk factor related to two elements, vulnerability, the limitation of migrant for improve in the new country, and the stressors, the difficulties live in the new country. The country or the new country is hostile. For me, it's very important to study these two elements, vulnerability and stressor, for to understand the risk factors in mental health for the migrants. And we have a scale that I will explain after, related to study the vulnerability and the stressors. Immigrating in extreme situation, the Ulysses syndrome. From general perspective, migration, mental health and psychopathology, we know today that the psychopathology is universal. There are data on the World Health Organization, very important studies that show that there are similar mental disorders in all the planet. And the explanation is this disorder are related to evolution. Yeah, and the reality is that the psychopathology is universal. And we can see three very important studies that show this idea. There are a debate about if the migrants have more risk of psychosis than other populations. There are contradictory studies, but there are a debate. In other disorders, the idea is that the pathology in migrants is very similar to general population. But in the area of psychosis, there are studies that show that an increased risk in migrants. Incremented risk of psychosis in immigrants related to big activity of dopaminergic system, related also to social exclusion. Social exclusion is very important factor related to psychosis. And the migrants live very, very extreme situations. There are also studies that show that increased risk of psychosis in immigrants living separately, isolated from the group of belonging. There are more risk of psychosis. However, there is also research that show that when immigrants leave their group a little, they integrate a little in the host society. They have less social progress. The separation, radical separation of the group of belonging is problematic, but no entry in the new society is problematic also for the migrant, for the integration, for putting pro in the new society. And the majority of migrants are resilient people, don't have mental disorder, but live psychological difficulties. This is the idea of the Ulysses syndrome. No a mental disorder, a suffrance, a suffering, a very difficult mental situation related to a extreme stress or to live extreme mourning. And I begin my presentation about the Ulysses syndrome. Ulysses syndrome has two elements, the extreme stressors that leave the migrant and the reactive symptoms related to this situation. The symptom is an intent of adaptation, obviously, from evolutionary perspective, for example. I consider that there are four very important stressors related to Ulysses syndrome. Forced solitude, everything for the children, but without the children, everything were missing. It's terrible, the long line, the solitude of millions of migrants. Maria has not seen her children in Bolivia for more than 1,000 days.
Manolo.
And this suffering is very important because it related to attachment, a central concept in today's psychology. And for millions of migrants, attachment is broke. I remember the case of an Ecuadorian boy who had regrouped, explaining in the consultation that had said to himself, be tough, harden your heart. He was very afraid to bond with his parents again. It's an expression of the suffering related to separation in migration. Ecuador, Chunchi, in the Andes, the village of suicidal children. 62 children had committed suicide. Because it's terrible also the situation for the children, no only for the father, for the parents. And these children live a parental mutilation, child orphans to living parents. Millions of children living terrible situation also for mental health in the country of origin, the parents in the countries of migration, but everybody live a situation of terrible stress. This is an archetypal image of migration in Ellis Island in New York, your city in New York. But it's a museum image. Today, except for rich people, it is very difficult to emigrate with the family. This is an image for a museum. Image of the migration of today. In other times, it was possible to migrate with the family, is in literature. Other stressors, very important, are the lack of opportunities and the fight for survival. Everybody know this terrible image. And the fourth element is very important also is the fear, the terror in the today migrations. This is a boat with migrants that left the coast of Africa. The idea was to go to Canary Island, but this boat finished the trip in the Caribbean. It's a terrible image of the difficulties of today migration. Chairman in the Mexican United States border. Everybody know the beast. But this situation exists in all the planet. We have one organization, the Athena Network, with colleagues of many countries, Asia, Africa, America, Europe. And the situation is terrible in all the planet. Violence is ever greater with women. Live more stress to the point that the migratory trip is not recommended without the Dopo Provera. It's a terrible situation for women especially. And the fear is very important aspect from a psychological perspective. In the Maslow model, a basic model in psychology, the safeness is the second more important need. You're not free if you don't feel safe. Millions of migrants don't feel safe. And this situation is related to mental suffering, to mental stress. I think that Ulysses syndrome is a form of social mobbing, making someone's life impossible. It's a social mobbing. I think also that there are characteristics of the stressors in the Ulysses syndrome. There are general stressors, but have specific characteristics. Multiplicity, chronicity, it is not just a bad day. Lack of control in psychology is very important, the idea of control of stress, the work of Seligman, for example. High intensity and relevance of the stressors, lack of social support, social capital, the model of Coleman. There are the acculturative stress, but also stress of survival. And also, there are two very important elements. Many times, there are a trivialization or lack of interest in the social system, medical system, related to suffering of migrants, but other times there are a medicalization of migratory mourning. Many times these migrants are treated as depressive, psychotics, having adjustment disorder or somatic disorder. In many cases are not mental disorder or physical disorder, are stress, the expression of stress in the mental functioning or physical functioning. And the risk is to medicalize the suffering related to migratory mourning. Ulysses syndrome is not only seen in Europe, in the States, it's in all the planet. There are a lot of migration south-south. The migration is not only south-north. It's the south-south, yeah, and very important level of migration. The immigrants are the sixth continent, a mobile continent. In Europe, in the States, the population is getting older, but the borders are closed. In Europe, more dippers are used for the elderly and for children, but the borders are closed. We are health and social science professional, and we cannot remain silent in the face of these painful realities and so much suffering, I think. I continue my presentation. Symptomatology of the Pleaser syndrome. The symptomatology is related to expression of stress. Symptoms of the area of depression, sadness, crying, but are no apathy, ideas of death, guilt, and is suffering is not the same that the problem of people with depressive disorder. Sadness and crying is not symptomatology enough for the diagnosis of depressive disorder. Many migrants don't have apathy. On the contrary, they are proactive. This situation is not related with depression. Symptoms of the area of anxiety, tension, nervousness. Symptoms of the area of somatization, insomnia, migraine. I utilize this name in migraine because the two words are related: in migration, migration, migraine. And I utilize this word in migraine. We have studies in our consultation in Barcelona, in the Harbor of Barcelona, in the Sapira of Service, that 76% of migrants with headaches, with in-migraine. And this headache is related to tension, to difficulty for life in the terrible situation that live a lot of migrants. Symptoms also of the confusional area for me, this situation is similar to Spock's in the book Waiting for Godot, situation of confusion, of difficulty to have hope in the future, but the human being had the capacity to hope a solution, Waiting for Godot, no? Many times in the consultation, I have been this experience, no? Migrants living in the disappearance, in the confusion, but with the hope for a solution, for a help, no? And for me, it's this situation of confusion, of not to see a solution is related to this important book of theater, no? Waiting for Godot. And also, is very important the cultural interpretation of the symptomatology. It's important to have a broad vision, cosmovision, and understand that there are many different cosmovision cultures, and to have respect for other visions of the world. Traditional medicine considers that anyone who becomes ill has broken a societal rule. The affected person then resort to witchcraft to make him ill. It's a very interesting community perspective of mental or physical problems. And the social psychology is in the same line. Is the mental problems are related to problems with the communication, with the situation of these people in the community, the relationships. Description of how the concept of Ulysses syndrome arise. Around the year 2000, the border are closed in Europe. Immigrants began to arrive at Sapir House, a consultory, who explained situation of forced lonely lines, fear, defenseless, the impossibility of moving forward in the host society. For me, this situation was new, different from the situation of the migrants in the 80s, in the 90s. And I did a statistic of the symptoms and discomforts that they referred to me, and I saw that there were no the symptoms of typical mental disorder, anxiety disorder, depression. This symptomatology is different. And the context was terrible. It's the origin of the idea of Ulysses syndrome. In 2002, I described this concept. I continue. Differential diagnosis. It's important to understand. That is different to leave Ulysses stressors are long lines, fear, but the Ulysses syndrome is a symptomatology related to leave this problematic as extreme migratory morning, but other people with these stressors develop a mental disorder. For that is very important, the vulnerability. These stressors are terrible. The majority of migrants no develop mental disorder, but a small group with a lot of vulnerability in this situation develop a mental disorder. All the presentation is right, you can read the text. Differential diagnosis with depressive disorder is different. Absence of apathy, thoughts of death are proactive. Is a phenomenologically different kind of sadness, more in the line of desolation, described by Ignacio de Loyola, for example. There are many expressions of sadness. One part of this sadness is related to pathology, to depressive disorder. But there are a lot of sadness that form part of the life. No, is not related to mental disorder. In this book, it is suggested that in recent years, there has been a strong tendency to confuse sadness with depression. It's very different, sadness than depression. The migrants with Ulysses syndrome have sadness, but no depression. Other important differential diagnosis is with the adjustment disorder. Adjustment disorder is defined in the DSM-5. A severe complaint superior to that anticipated given the nature of stress. The Ulysses syndrome is a natural response of an inhumane stress is proportional. The idea of adjustment disorder is disproportion between the stressor and response. No problem, because the stressors are terrible. Other important differential diagnosis is with traumatic, post-traumatic stress disorder. For the diagnosis of post-traumatic stress disorder, we need intrusive thoughts in relation to traumatic situation, avoidance behavior, apathy. The majority of migrants don't have this problematic. I think that there is a overdiagnosis of post-traumatic stress disorder. The 15, 20 or percent of people suffering traumatic events develop post-traumatic disorder. And the migrants are people with a lot of resilience. It's a selection of population with a lot of resilience and have more capacity to resist the situation, the traumatic situation. Trauma is not the same as post-traumatic stress disorder. Today, there are a tendency to confusion. The Homo sapiens sapiens have resilience and capacity to elaborate the trauma. We have a group in the UC Davis in Sacramento for the study of this analysis, no? The traumatic stress disorder and Ulysses syndrome. However, alcoholism is a mental disorder and very important. It's underdiagnosed. Alcoholism is considered a cultural issue. But the alcoholism is related with gender violence, sexual abuse, a lot of problems, accidents. The alcoholism has terrible effects in the migrant. But it's few students, it's not considered disorder. The Ulysses syndrome is more like a prodrome than a mental disorder. The immigrant who suffers from the Ulysses syndrome has a healthy personality, is sensitive, is like a reed which bend in the stone, but do not break and recover a right stance. I think this vision image is interesting. Ulysses syndrome is in the border between mental health and mental disorder. It's a difficult situation for mental health, but it's not mental disorder. The risk is the medicalization, the victimization, but also the trivialization, the banalization, is a problem related to mental health, but is not a mental disorder. The Ulysses syndrome is in the area of psychosocial intervention, psychoeducational intervention. I will explain after. This is a program in Berkeley University, intervention in California, and the Ulysses syndrome is considered in the center of the problematic in mental health. But other problem is that psychiatric diagnosis is very complicated. It's very ideological, cultural, and I think that it's important to debate, no, this idea. It's important for me to read Foucault and the idea that the mental disorder is related to biopower. And it's important to understand the power that we have in the psychiatrists, psychologists, and why this power related to society, to model of society, very important this debate. This is the concept of biopolitics in Foucault. But you know this concept, but it's important. This framework of our intervention is in the mark of biopolitics. Extreme example, I was diagnosed with rebellious delusional psychosis. He's a man against the system in a dictatorial country. Diagnosed with rebellious delusional psychosis. It's the risk of psychiatry also. If it's too much related to power. I think that the psychological work must help the liberation, the freedom of the person, not the normalization, the social normalization. It's a very interesting work. Liberation, the freedom. Other interesting idea is the immigrant as the colonized. Edward said, points in cultural imperialism, Western writers have often made people from other cultural, the colonized, invisibles in their works. It's important the analysis from perspective of the colonization. In the classic work, Caliban, the Shakespeare, is a character who has no life. A native don't have personality. Only the Europeans have personality. This, for me, very important also, this perspective. Get to know anti-colonial thinkers and understand other cosmovisions, other ideas. Also, intersectional perspective with the concept related to LGTBI and the complexity of society. I continue another part, what the data tell us about the Ulysses syndrome. 15% of immigrants visited with Ulysses syndrome. In various studies, this is the proportion, the number of migrants with Ulysses syndrome in general consultation, in psychiatric consultation. But we see the tip of the iceberg. A lot of migrants don't go to visit, to consultation. Migrants have fear, have exclusion, and we see the tip of iceberg. This study in our center is the same number. And we have an Ulysses Syndrome Institute in London for the research related to Ulysses Syndrome. There are a video, but it's problematic to now. It's possible to entry in the web. We have in this part of London. And Ulysses syndrome is created for disseminate and promote the concept of Ulysses syndrome to create a documentation center. We have many articles and research published about the Ulysses syndrome for the researches that desire to know the documentation about the Olyse syndrome, to offer advisory service related to tests and research, information. It's a center created for develop the concept. There are doctoral dissertations and research related to Olyse syndrome. This is the web of the institute. I continue my presentation. We have here a very, very important part, the assessment. It's very important, the assessment, for to do a good intervention. Assessment is the basis of the intervention. We have to know and properly measure the reality on which we are going to intervene. We have two tests for the study of migration and mental health. The Ulysses scale or risk factors, vulnerability and stressors, and the kayak test related to mechanisms of elaboration of migratory mourning. Very different test. The Ulysses scale measures the context of the migrant, but the scale measures the functioning for the elaboration of the migratory mourning. I will explain briefly the two tests. Is the Ulysses scale, and this is the kayak test. The Ulysses scale is related to seven griefs, seven mournings, and vulnerability and stressors. Is the connection between the two elements, the two concepts. Vulnerability, the limitations with the subject migrate, the baggage of limitation, stressors, the difficulties lives in the new country, the example of undocumented migrant. We can indicators of every morning related to vulnerability and stressors. If you are interested in my web, it's possible to know the test and the utilization. This is the utilization of the test, the mornings, vulnerability, stressors. It's related to English also. The comparisons between different patients, we can see the intensity of vulnerability in every morning. And it's interesting for understand the risk related to mental health of the migrant. This is the text in Spanish and English. There are the studies of fiability, consistency of the test. And the other test is the kayak test. The kayak test is a different test, sorry. It's a different test because it related to mechanisms of elaboration, not the context, the inside, the functioning, the mental functioning related to elaboration of migratory mourning. It's based in evolutionary psychology. I was professor of evolutionary psychology many years or so, and it's based in evolutionary psychology. And it's very simple to understand. There are two axes, one axis to activity, few activity, a lot of activity. And a second axis related to direction of activity. And from evolutionary perspective, there are two very important directions in our action. Exploration, and to have resources, and protect the resources, security. There are the two directions of our behavior. We cross the axis and we can see four areas related to the cross of the axis. And the idea of the kayak is for the compensation, the equilibrium, is a model based in the equilibrium. And four borders, streams. In the center of the model, there are the integrated mental functioning. In the extreme, the more psychotic, radical, disadapted. It's a model of continuum. And we can see in this model mental functioning. Control in the extreme is obsessive disorder. Assertiveness is in the extreme, paranoia. Retreat is in the extreme, isolation. Well, is a model based in to work with the cross of the two axes. We can see very briefly the areas. Center and extreme. The control is good, but the obsessive functioning is not adaptive. Assertiveness is good, but if everybody there are confrontation, conflict, is not adaptive. The capacity to retreat is good, but the isolation is a very important problem. The capacity to self-criticism. Criticism is good, but the culpability is the extreme. Culpability is very problematic for mental health. Rethinking is good, but the functioning of confusion is negative. Rest is good, but the passivity is not adaptive, not adaptive. Exploration is very important, but the risk is disorganization. And action is good, but the mania is a problematic functioning. It's not adaptive, the results are very bad, not adaptive. This is the idea of the kayak test. And this test we utilize in clinic also, but I utilize also this test for the study of migratory morning, the seven mornings. It's interesting for me, the more easy to understand is the morning for the language. For example, it's good to clarify the study of a new language, but the obsessive will learn all the grammar of the new language perfectly. It's not adaptive. It's impossible to know all the grammar. The obsessive won this absolute control. Other people have attitude of paranoia, refusal of the new language. It's bad and it's not adaptive. Other people have a posture of delay, of to pad distance, no one to accept the necessity of the new language. We can see different attitudes related to learn a new language. Obsessive, all, refusal, no, delay, depressive functioning. I cannot learn the new language. It's impossible. No, no. It's no adaptive mechanism. Passivity. Pues, problematic. The disorganization and the mania, learn English in a week. The mania are expressions of bad elaboration of learning of the language. In the center, there are the capacities, control, assertiveness, acceptation of limitation. But in the extreme, there are the pathological functioning or disadaptive functioning. And we can indicators for every morning. I can explain all, but are in the book how the test. The indicators related to every morning from the perspective of this test. I can show a case. We can read the case of Maria. Maria is an example of Maria with Ulysses syndrome. Living extreme situation, separation, suffering a lot. And develop a symptomatology not too much relevant, but symptomatology in the area of obsessive functioning and culpability. And we can see the equilibrium, the obsessive functioning finish with depression, and the depression, many times, the reaction is to control to obsessive functioning. It's a, in clinic, in the clinical, a typical example of compensation. And we can study related to mourning by the family the functioning of this woman. And we can help this woman to organize better the functioning of migratory mourning. We can, the schemes of the test. And this is the idea, no? Yeah, I think that the example of language is very, very clear. Recapitulating, we have begun studying the context of current migration, the stressors that immigrant experience, the symptoms, the assessment, and finally, the intervention. But the intervention is related to have a good assessment. Intervention, psychological, psychosocial, cross-cultural perspective. It's important no medicalize migratory mourning. And perspective, psychosocial, psychoeducational, and cross-cultural. And three parts, the program of community mental health intervention, the intervention in situation of radical exclusion, and psychotherapeutic intervention in migratory. Three parts. This community intervention is based in three concepts: vulnerability, stressor, and symptomatology. The combination of the three elements is the basis of the plan of intervention. And we have this scheme, this model. We can see that there are four possibilities: high vulnerability, no extreme stressor, mental disorder. So there are the combination of the three elements develop four situation, four types of cases, four types of intervention. And for us, it's important because we tend to organize better the intervention. If we understand the vulnerability of this case, if live esteem stressors or no, if have symptomatology of mental disorder or no, is different to the symptomatology of stress or the Ulysses syndrome. The combination of the three elements is the basis of this model for the intervention. It's important also the cultural approach. I have this model. There are 9 differences with cultures related to mental functioning, related to individuality, to guilt, in body. There are differences between cultures, and it's important to understand these differences for to have a good intervention. It's important also this the colonial perspective, recognizing the contribution of cultures. Ignacio Martín Baró, for example, Social Psychology Liberation in Latin America, is very important to know the work of a lot of professionals. The second point is the intervention in situations of radical social exclusion, the idea of extended therapeutic relationships. When migrants leave a situation of extreme exclusion, is important to understand the elements of hostility, somatization, because the intensity of suffering is expressed in the negative transference, and is important for the professional know the feelings of people living this situation. The elements of hostility, somatization of the suffering, and from perspective of the professional, there are feelings of helplessness, frustration, burnout, a world with population in extreme social radical exclusion is live also of problematic form for the professional. Frustration, burnout. And the third point is psychotherapeutic intervention and migratory mourning. I visit online people, for example, migrants who live complicated situation in the new countries. This is the case for Alicia. It changed the name and the country, but this is the idea. Alicia is an example of young migrant living difficulties in the elaboration of migratory mourning. It's no extreme situation, help Ulysses, but it's a complicated migratory mourning, and is important also to work from the perspective of elaboration of migratory mourning. We can read. And it's important in general to utilize different possibilities to religious level, cultural, sporting. I think that there are strategies from psychosocial perspective to individual level or groupal level. To individual level strategies at the mental and emotional level and the physical level, it's important to utilize the physical and the mental functioning. And there are different strategies related to this type of intervention. All is in my book, Inteligencia Migratoria, and there are the explanation of these models. The physical level is very important also because the stress is expressed in form of somatization. Intervention related to migratory mourning. Intervention related to 12 characteristics of migratory mourning and the 7 mournings. At a group level, strategies at mental and emotional level, psychosocial level, social level, cultural level. There are different possibilities. It's important to psychosocial level participation in self-management and self-organization groups. You know, the risk is the paternalism, the control is important. The self-organization of the group of migrants. Participation in social groups. There are a model, possibilities to help to leave the migratory mourning. Legal support. There are the group, the possibilities of intervention. And if we understand all the possibilities, it's better for to help the mayor. This is the book, Inteligencia Migratoria. And finally, why Ulysses? I finish my intervention. Ulysses, in order to dignify the figure of the immigrant, is the hero of the today world. In order to approach this JavaScript from an emotional standpoint, the press have spoken of odysseys when referring to the immigrants' journeys. A lot of text in the Odyssey explain the suffering that we had in our consultation. This is a text of Odyssey, very clear, no, in the expression of suffering. This is the trip, a migrant from Cameroon. This migrant crossed all the center of Africa to the north after arrived to the Canary Island from the Sahara, is in prison, is deported to Madrid, to the peninsula. It's a terrible trip. This is a trip of Ulysses from Troya to Ithaca. It's no exaggeration to say that the trip of migrant is an odyssey. A lot of text in the Odyssey explain the suffering of the family. The suffering is for all the family. Similar, I explain, no? The family, the children in America, live in extreme situation, is the same, is described in the Odyssey. However, it is not a single man. Today, a million of migrants live in this situation. Bad times are those when ordinary people must behave like heroes in order to survive. Ulysses was a semi-god and lived extreme situation. Today, millions of people live the same situation. The belief in magic and witchcraft in the Odyssey is important also. The dangers, the enemies represented by Polyphemus. I think that is very interesting, this idea. You ask me, Cyclops, my name. I tell you, my name is nobody, and nobody is what everyone calls me. If in order to survive, one has to be no one, can no be either identity, social integration, self-esteem, and mental health cannot exist. Nobody is in confrontation with mental health. We had two times in the European Parliament with the work related to Ulysses syndrome, in United Nations also. This is awarded in the Berkeley University for this research. It's interesting. Ulysses syndrome is utilized to legal level. There are sentences to legal level utilizing the Ulysses syndrome. It's interesting. It's used in this novel of Santiago Gamboa, in Colombia, in this book of poetry, theater translated to different languages. This is the Chavez Award. For me, very, a lot of honor to receive this, this award. And others, awards of the work in this line. This is the book. I described the Ulysses syndrome in 2002. Other edition of the book. The Ulysses syndrome is discovered during a deconstruction of the diagnosis. And I think that is important, the differentiation between mental suffering, mourning, and mental disorder. This is our center in Barcelona. We work in this area of the harbor, the Barcelona, the area of arriving of migration. We have this organization, Atena Network, for work, colleagues of many countries for help migrants in extreme situations. Finally, the idea of romanizing migration is the beginning and the romanizing migration. Ulysses finally returned with her family. We hope that this dream will be resolved, the dream of millions of migrants into the world. And my social networks, if you are interested. And thank you very much for the attention, and we can to have a time for the delay, the her your applications. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, Josiba. That was amazing and such a fascinating thing to learn about, and how you've distinguished it from the symptomatology that I think we often associate with immigrants. It's very important work, and you can see it's important work as it's resonated so widely across the globe.
Thank you.
We do have two questions in our Q&A. If you'd like to take a look at those presentations, and feel free to stop screen sharing so we can all see each other. But please, for folks, please drop any questions you have in the chat, and we'll spend about the next 30 minutes or so, going through these questions.
Very well, I can see. There are comments,
Yes.
But I don't see the questions. The text, I will send the text to Ashley for everybody, all the PowerPoint. There are more questions, or I don't
see. So I see one here. The first question I see is, understanding that mental illness can often be overdiagnosed, is there a benefit to overdiagnosing mental disorders by providing migrants with intense emotional reactions to extreme circumstances with mental health resources? So essentially saying, you raise the point that there's this overdiagnosis of mental disorders amongst immigrants. Do you see that there are benefits to that sometimes, in the sense that maybe they'll get put in place with health resources, or is there a problem with the overdiagnosis? What's your perspective?
I think there are a debate in psychology and psychiatry about this issue, no? The overdiagnosis today, the idea of the suffering of the normal life is not a mental disorder. And situation of the everyday life are not the situation of stress are no situation of mental disorder. I think it's important because the risk is the medicalization with psychopharmacology, very hard, victimization. There are cases with mental disorder, but the majority don't have mental disorder. Are stress similar to Ulysses syndrome, in my experience.
And the second question that I see here is, does the Ulysses syndrome tend to resolve itself over time? Is that something that you see that the Ulysses syndrome will go away over time, or does it respond to treatment?
You can clean more iron.
So if someone is, you know, if you've done your evaluation and someone is said to have the Ulysses syndrome, not just the symptoms, but the full syndrome, does it resolve itself over time? Does it get better over time by itself, or is it something that responds well to treatment? And if so, what does that treatment maybe look like?
That I understand. We can help to migrant with Ulysses syndrome, but as the cause, the origin of the problem is social, is very difficult to resolve the question because it's a social problem. And we can improve the capacity to resist the stress, to capacity to elaboration of the situation, the resilience. But in my experience, the Ulysses syndrome disappeared while migrant live in good condition. While migrant has the document, the possibility to live without fear, without situation of extreme stress, the Ulysses syndrome disappear because it's a reaction of a difficult situation. It's similar to mobbing, to burnout, is related to conditions. When situations in the work improve, the mobbing or the burnout disappear. When the situation of persecution of the migrant disappear, in migrant with a health functioning, migrants without mental disorder, the fear disappear, this migrant is in situation of relaxation, and I think that we can help the migrant to increase the resilience, but to resolve completely the situation, I think that is not possible because it's a external problem.
So migratory mourning is resolving itself by increasing the quality of life and the standard of life of the immigrant. It's what I'm hearing you say. And so it almost, you know, there for everybody on the call, there are representatives here from organizations across the United States, from different departments of health, from different hospitals that provide care to immigrants. And so you know, it's important for us to, in this space, be thinking about how we can leverage our own institutions to be increasing maybe that quality of life that could help to resolve some of the Ulysses syndrome symptomatology. Am I understanding that correctly, Josiba?
I think that it is important to understand the situation. It's important the debate is complex, the analysis, the assessment. For that, I consider that is very important, the assessment, a good assessment. And it's important the differentiation with the Ulysses syndrome and mental disorder, and we need the capacity to do a good assessment. That is the basis of a good intervention, no? But it's important to know this problematic, the debate, the training. I think there are a lot of migrants diagnosed as depressives, with anxiety disorder, in reality, don't have mental disorder. And the risk is the radical treatment with psychopharmacology. And when the problem is psychosocial, is psychoeducational, is not medical, is the psychosocial area.
Thank you. So one final question I see in the question and answer box here is just a clarification about migration barriers. So someone said that we have laws like the Moroni Law, which penalize immigration, so internal immigration, not immigration. So do you also expect to see Ulysses syndrome in those who attempted to migrate but failed? It's less of maybe the distance from family, some of those the pieces of isolation, but they've attempted and failed and maybe come back. So I wanted to just this participant wanted to know if you could expect to see the symptomatology in those immigrants as well.
The symptomatology is variable. The majority have a headache, have symptomatology of nervousness. In some cases, there are symptomatology to level mental confusion. The majority are symptomatology of sadness, but sadness without apathy. Sadness, but with the capacity to struggle, to work, to share possibilities to improve, is not a sadness as the sadness of depression without possibility to work, no? Is a sadness related to mourning, not to mental disorder. In psychology, there are a long debate the differences between mourning and depression. This is a good example. This sadness is related to mourning, not with depression. It's related to a specific problematic, no, related to a problem in the mental functioning. The majority of migrants are health people, resilient people.
I see
Questions
two other
in the chat
questions.
also? Ah, sí. There are more questions. Yes.
Yes, in the chat, please.
Yes. Ahí. Yes, a question about the problematic related to employment is in South Africa. Greetings to colleagues of South Africa. This colleague is explaining the difficulties to work with this problematic. I explain the difficulty in the work with people in extreme exclusion related to hostility, to negative transference, to somatization. In these cases, it's important for me the proximity, the personal proximity. Because the problem is not only a mental problem, it's a problem of survival, it's a more deep problem. And it's important to understand the suffering of this migrant, the tension that live, and to have empathy, no, for the contact, no, with proximity. For us, it's the same situation in Spain that in South Africa. I think in all the planet, the problematic is very, very similar. Other question is about the crisis of identity. I think that is a very interesting questions. When people live a personal crisis so intense, very difficult situation, the identity is also in crisis. Is related to difficulty to reorganize the life, no? And the identity entry also in situation of crisis. In some cases, in radicalization or confusion, but crisis. There are different types of functioning, no? But when people leave situation extreme, all the personality is in situation of tension and crisis. Other question, how can we educate in a country that use jails for penalized migration, criminalized migration? Obviously, obviously. Migration is a right, it's a human right, but today the criminalization of migration, which is a terrible, terrible problem. I think that in this area is important the social debate, the show, the discomfort with these politics, the political intervention, because it's criminalization is a political attitude. It's important to organize the response against these politics, I think. Other question, the criminalization. Question about identity also. I think that the identity for me is a construction, a deconstruction, is a process. The building and change is not a process. It's a process with changes, with rethinkings. It's good to reanalyze the identity, but in extreme situation, is possible to leave the identity more problematically, no? It's difficult to have the equilibrium to understand the identity, no? In this situation of extreme suffering. Very
I don't see
interesting
any.
the question. Thank you.
I don't see any other questions, and I know we have a couple more minutes. I'm going to sneak one of my own questions into it. I was going to ask if you have seen differences in extreme migratory mourning between youth and adults, if you kind of see it present differently between youth and adults. I'm curious.
Very interesting question. There are differences because the child has a mental functioning different to the adult, and in the child, the situation is worse, is more problematic. In the adult, there are more possibilities to respond to adaptation. The child is limited for the situation of to be child, but also for the familiar context, normally in crisis. The family is disestructured. and the child live with more difficulty than adult the situation of extreme migration. The risk is more important in a child from perspective of mental health.
Okay, and I do see one more question here. This is from Mariel, who says, I conduct immigration evaluations for people seeking asylum. How can we address this as we are trying to help the individual access documents to work and to have access to other resources? So, how do we stay mindful of extreme migratory mourning and Ulysses syndrome as we're processing asylum applications and bringing people
Yes.
into the US?
See, my idea is that these stressors and this symptomatology appear in all the situation of extreme migration, refugees, undocumented migrants. When the situation is extreme, this symptomatology appear is a response to extreme stress, a refugee, undocumented migrant, migrant with documents but with difficulties to live in family. A lot of situations are related to extreme stress in migration, and the symptomatology for me is similar. Is the same.
Would, for this person, would you say that by helping the individual in the process, by helping them access working documents, by helping them access resources, is that a form of intervention of someone with extreme migratory mourning? Is there more that they could be doing beyond, putting them in touch with resources and kind of their interactions with these individuals?
The intervention, no, related to the intervention for me is very the more important is the psychosocial perspective. In second level, the psychoeducational, but for me, the more important is the psychosocial help, no, relationship with the autochthonous community, participation in activities with the autochthonous, help in the demand related to contact with association. For me, the psychosocial level is the most important related to intervention in the Ulysses syndrome. It's different to medical intervention, psychotherapeutical. It's fundamentally a psychosocial intervention, contention to tension, to suffering of the other. Also, the psychoeducational perspective to help to immigrant to understand the suffering than live. Understand that the suffering is related to a context and to help from a psychosocial perspective to improve with relationship, with activities, with self-organization, to improve the self-esteem, improve the capacity to resist the stress.
Thank you. I think that's all of the questions that our group has for you.
Bueno, for the email, I
Yes,
can.
please.
It's no problem.
Absolutely.